Good morning, everyone. I'd like to talk today about technique of javelin throwing, and I would say better the understanding of javelin throw, which is a big difference and very important that you, as javelin thrower or coaches, understand the way of throwing, what's important, what's the positions, and the basic of javelin throw. As country with the background of cricket, many or quite a lot of athletes coming from cricket or playing cricket, and I learned here that quite a lot of javelin thrower use a little bit the style of cricket with a long arm, with a shoulder forward, and that's important that you understand and learn as early as possible the difference between the movements by bowling a ball in cricket or throwing a ball for distance, ball or javelin or... we have here quite a lot different sports, which are overhead throws sports, and all pretty much bend the elbow to use the advantage of not only using the shoulder for the throw, for the acceleration, no, but more that you use also the forearm and hand much better. So when you start throwing, you can use a lot of different implements, if it's light balls, golf balls, tennis balls, baseballs, cricket, or nerve, vortex, nerve, fin flyer, probably here in India, not that many know about this, but it's for example very soft javelin kind for beginner implement, and it's very good for the joints in develop throwers in young age. Yeah. And it's pretty similar to a javelin, yeah, shorter, bit heavy, but I think it's much better than turbo jav because the grip it's smaller and special for little hands, much better. Or you take bamboo sticks. It's also soft, and you learn, you can learn the fundamentals with this bamboo stick. If you see here the basic structure of the throw for, that's I think a 10-year-old boy from Hungary. And it's, you see direct that the technique, it's much similar, much different than the technique of cricket bowling. Yeah, nice to see the body position leaning a bit backwards, using the hip, and then using this throwing shoulder and whip from the forearm and hand, which make a big difference. We have these three different kind of grips. The American grip I used and at my time, throwing time, not direct this because I didn't use the thumb behind the cord, but I've found this very, very good and controlled grip. Then the foregrip, it's not so common. Some thrower use it. I couldn't find the connection to it. Some coaches say that's very nice for elbow. I think you can protect your elbow with other ways of good technique. And then the finish grip, where the middle finger is behind the cord. This time it's probably the most common grip. Jan Železný used, Thomas Röhler used, Neeraj used it. So many of the top thrower use this. But it's a personal thing. Everybody should find the best way for himself. I like to talk about key positions of the javelin throw. And here it's a training throw from Jan Železný in South Africa in Potchefstroom. And one in the first picture, in the first picture, you see his sideways position. The arm could be a little bit higher than the javelin, the shoulder axe, and the hip axe pretty much parallel. But you see that he is active from pulling with the left leg into the cross step, impulse step. The shoulder axe, hip axe showing to this time in throwing position. And that's continue until he is landing with the right after the cross step. You see at the picture four, for example, his foot position. It's about 45 to 60 degrees to the throwing direction. Many athletes coming to me, also Anu, for example, started before with foot straight in throwing direction. That means that the hip is turning forward, open. Yeah, it can't stay. The axe can't stay in throwing direction, which destroy a lot of impulse we get from the right foot and from the right hip. On the picture 4, you see also we have marked the parallelitate. It's almost perfect from the hip axe, shoulder axe, and javelin, which is also important. I will show you later what happened if it's not like this. On the picture 5, you see, Jan, it's pushing from right foot into his knee, which is going horizontal forward. It's not get straight and push him over his left leg. It goes horizontal into the left block. And he is building a nice C position, means a bow position with his, from his right foot over the knee, hip, shoulder, into the arm. And the arm could probably a little bit higher, but it's also a little bit personal style. It can have also influence on stress on elbow. We'll see later with other athletes. On the picture 6 and 7, you see how stable the left block is. That's also very important. We have to get the speed from the right side into a stable block to accelerate the javelin, to have a great anchor point of the body to pull on the javelin and be able to accelerate and get a high release speed. So here we have some other positions. Here you see how active, you see really the activity and how he goes into the cross step. Yeah? It's pulling from left side and swinging from the right side. But always with the hip and shoulder axe back, yeah, sideways to the throwing direction. Landing, or just before landing after cross step, you see leaning back with the upper body, very important. Many athletes, young athletes, try to throw only hard with the upper body, but the throw build up from the ground, from the feet, from speed, with activity of the legs, and for good block and bow tension, we have to be first back with our upper body. Also to have a long acceleration pull on the javelin. Upper body leaning back 20 to 30 degrees. So body mass point should be over or even light behind the right landing leg. And here you see also again these 45 to 60 degree foot position. Yeah. Start to move into the block and still has this 45 degrees foot position. The hip shows still in throwing direction. Yeah, then pull step, it's a link between run up and throw. And the run up, it's very important, and many throwers are fast, but also many throwers losing speed at the impulse step. Yeah? And impulse step has a name from giving an impulse, so increasing speed. And Jan Železný was a master of it. Yeah? We had in Halle a big throwing meeting every year. And in some of his last years, I think it was in 2004, they measured the speed during his run-up and compared to other throwers there. And he was the only one who increased his speed during the impulse step. All other losing speed, only concentrate on throwing hard. But he's his best weapon was his legs and how fast he built up his body position and his bow position. Yeah, keep body behind center of gravity. That's I told you already. Here is Jan and demonstrate at the Kurtane World Javelin Conference a few years ago how the throw build up from the right foot, setting sideways, probably a little bit too much than we think it's good. So 45, 60 degrees, and then pushing from the foot into the knee against the strong left block. And doing the whole time, you see how stable and close his shoulder is. His left shoulder from picture one to picture two, even his right foot push forward, but the shoulder goes inwards to close the left side to get a better block and get from light rotation movement in a straight linear throw. If you take move your left shoulder too early backwards or downwards, like many throwers are doing, you get more rotation into the block and not work direct against left. his marked how the foot is moving, and the on the picture too, in which direction the power line goes. Yeah? The push goes horizontal. Into the knee and then into the hip to build up a big bow tension. Okay. Here you see me on top demonstrate the using of forearm and hand with a handball, and down this Cassie Mitchell, you see also bending the arm, have a good bow tension in the shoulder, and whipping the throw. The most parameters which influence distance of throw with ball or javelin is the release velocity by magnitude and direction. Yeah? Release velocity as a most influence, but only if it's in the right or in the optimal direction. That means release angle and release angle for a ball. It's optimal between 45 and 35 and 40 degrees, depending of the implement and of sure also on wind conditions. If you had headwind, you have to throw lower with tailwind a bit higher. For the javelin, it's a little bit lower. We think that's between 32 with headwind and up to 40 degrees with no wind or tailwind. Then we have another parameter at the angle of attack. You see it from the side. It has to be as close as possible to zero. So the throwing direction and the actually release angle between this, it's called angle of attack. And that should be, if possible, zero. 0 degrees was Jan Železný's world record throw. 0 degrees was from Barbara Spotakova, the world record. So that's small as possible. The angle of jaw, you see when you look from the back, that's where the javelin throws into, and the actually yeah, where the javelin shows into and the actually throwing direction where he's moving. I have also some not so good example, and you will see here very clearly the meaning of these both angles. Here's a throw from Johannes Vetter in Potchefstroom, 91 meter 22. If you remember before the position from Jan Železný, if you see the first picture, Johannes goes direct with the upper body into the cross step and is pretty open. The foot shows almost in, the right foot shows almost in throwing direction. The hip, it's open, and he is not leaning 1 centimeter back. Very upper body oriented thrower. You would say, yeah, but he throws 91 meter or even further in Lucerne, 2018, but no, 17. But I think he has could throw much further if he had a better technique. On the picture two upright, picture three, need way too long to come down with the left block leg. And in this time, the upper body is already in front and very open. Left shoulder, left arm, it's open. And so he get a bow tension, but pretty much without to involve his hip, it's only his shoulder. And you see also on this picture five that it means also a lot of stress for the shoulder and elbow because of his upper body position so much in front. His arm is compared to this way too low, and you see on the picture six and seven where the throw is going to, yeah, way too high, and you see also how big or strong the bend on the javelin is. That's also a very clear sign that the angle of attack, it's way too high, and you lose a lot of speed, which he can't get into the javelin. Here we have a not so good throw, but probably a bit similar to the throw in Potchefstroom, if we would see the throw in Potchefstroom from the backside. With his upper body, he often move to the left side. The power goes not into the javelin. It goes, like I marked with red, in a totally different direction. He's not, not the only one. I'll show you later. Also one Indian athlete who moved way too much to left. We have to concentrate that all the power we have goes linear into the javelin. And here it's an example from bad angle of jaw. It's about 12 degrees. It's a little bit difficult to measure very correct. I think could be even a little bit bigger. Angle of jaw should also be small as possible to not lose speed on the and power into the javelin. Here we have a throw from Torkelsen from Oslo. You can look and see how linear he is going. Yeah, straight forward against the block and into the throw.
Tämän kisan kärjessä, mutta onko kauan? Sillä nyt heittoon vuoroon tulee Andreas Torkildsen, Norjan tänä kaudella. Tällä kaudella heittänyt Norjan ennätyksen 93 ja sitten lähti Torkildsenin veto. Ja jäs kaartaa pitkälle ja nyt menee yli 90 metriä. Siinä tuli tämän kisan johtoheitto Andreas Torkildsen kotiyleisönsä edessä. Räppäsee menemään, hän oli hirveässä kunnossa. Täällä alkaa heti jytä soimaan. Ja porukka innostuu aivan tosissaan.
Yeah, you see here that he is running straight and also after the throw. He is still moving straight over the block in throwing direction. He is looking, watching the whole time the javelin. Yeah, that's very important. That means your head is in the right position. So as your body, yeah, special upper body. We will see later if you throw a style like Neeraj with throwing or jumping behind the or diving behind the javelin. That's a little bit similar. It's different. Sorry. Here we have other very good throw from Thomas Röhler and similar. Yeah, all the run up straight over the block, straight and watching behind the whole time. He has a javelin in his view. And if you do this, first you can build a good bow tension, but also very good block against left hip, left shoulder, which gives a big impulse into the throw. And not moving to the left means also not have a big angle of jaw and throwing direct in the middle of the sector. Yeah. If you watch it again. And you see also the quality of the whole throw. The javelin lands quite flat for the new model. yeah, compare with other throwers. Same as here, another example. Jan is, Jan is moving or diving behind, but still straight. Yeah? If you watch him go over the block, he's not moving a little bit to the side, direct, straight into throwing direction. Have a look. And even with diving, he watched the javelin the whole time. Here we have Neeraj at the Asian Games. Yeah, he's not watching. Yeah, he's moving to the left side, and then even turn his back to the throw. It's you think it's cool, but it's destroy a little bit his block, left block, and he has two big angle of attack and angle of draw. And the javelin, it's landing almost on the left sector side. Yeah. You can also see the difference of how the javelin flies and blend. Yeah. It's far away from optimal flying. The modern javelins, they can fly these days very good if you throw them, fly, give them chance to fly, not only power and upper body. We have to get better there. His throw from this year in Potter's room. You see on the picture one, landing after the cross step, impulse step. It's okay with probably 30 degrees of foot position to the throwing direction. That's okay, but a little bit upright. He should be a little bit more leaning back with his upper body and a little bit down, like a slightly sitting position. So he has not to drop after landing with his body down. The second picture shows his contact with left leg, which is a okay position. You should compare with what I said before with Jelezny, for example, where his arm was, his right arm. It's a little bit too, it's a little bit too low. It's under the shoulder axe. Should be at least on the level of the shoulder axe. That's the problem of using the upper body a little bit too too early. You see also even more clearly on the picture three, how his upper body and shoulder goes forward, but the arm, it's in a too low position. The other important part I spoke before, it's the position of the left shoulder and the left arm. You see in the picture two and three, where his left arm goes, and it's not support the block, it's even destroy the block. Yeah? With the move of the left arm downwards, the left shoulder get weak, and he sinks with the left hip and left knee down. That's at the end, on the picture five on the bottom, he is getting a little bit stronger at the end, but yeah, he should be strong the whole time. Here we have pictured the areas from the world record from Chelesny. Compare his block with Neeraj. Yeah? First, this landing position, the picture three on the top, landing right, and his body, it's sideways and leaning back. And then working against a very strong left block. You see even how the energy against the foot, the left foot. The left knee not bent. Yeah, it's even hyper extend, and the left hip also not get really weak, it's strong into the block. Yeah, that was the main things for me, the important part. How I see the technique from javelin throwers, and you should also be aware that the main focus should be on being sideways. If it's Anu, Rani, or Rohit, they, when they came to me, they was pretty much frontal with the foot, and also with the right hip and the right shoulder. And now we have to work back on sideways, and that needs time, and often it's very, very difficult to change habits. You learn first wrong to change. Sometimes I spoke with other coaches, some athletes never be able to change. So it's very important that you do it right on the first place. Yeah? And with young athletes, you can also introduce this sideways technique into meatball throws. Meatball throws like short put. Yeah, with light meatballs, only as technique learning, rhythm learning, with impulse step, with one impulse or two impulse, leaning back and using the right hip. The throw build up from the bottom, foot, knee, hip, shoulder, arm. That's very important to know. And often we make or see often the mistake that special with young athletes, they only be concentrate on upper body. Yeah, upper body, and they like to apply force on the implement, but then they destroy the fundamentals. Yeah. That was the last bit to the technique. Here are some strength exercise for the shoulder girdle. Very important to start early with these exercises. In Germany, they had a study with overhead sports like volleyball and javelin thrower, and 70% of I think 14, 15 years old athlete had already shoulder problems. So they started a program with them to strengthen the shoulder, special. We see often the mistake that the backside of the shoulder will not get not enough exercises and not strong enough. So very important to strengthen the external rotators. And the rhomboids and the scapular stability. I don't like to get to every single exercise. Make a picture or you get the presentation later. Here also some other exercises you can play around with your athletes, but very important is to strengthen the back of the shoulder. That's the accelerators, and these muscles very important to stabilize the shoulder, and the biggest stress on the shoulder, it's doing the deceleration. And for that, you have to be prepared. Not only after you get injured, you can prevent injuries with exercise like these. One important shoulder stretch for javelin throwers is a sleeper stretch. You can do it like this girl here by yourself or by a coach. Important is if you do it with a supporting person, that you also stabilize your shoulder. And stretch and work on improvement. It should be weekly, at least twice, maybe three times a week. That earlier you start, the better you stay on this. We have here also in the camp with few athletes problems with these exercises, or with the shoulder and with the flexibility of the shoulder. And after we started these, it's improving very good. Stretch for external rotators, you can do it with the hand, or easier is it with a towel or a rubber band, or then some few words to the training of javelin throwers. Quite a lot athletes told me when I started here to work with them, oh coach, I never did jumps, single leg jumps, hops, or yeah, we never did something for coordination or gymnastic. And yeah, so it's very important that you work as athlete, or if you're a coach with your athlete, on to build up a javelin thrower who develop like a multi-event athlete. Yeah. A lot of athletes came from other sports like handball, but also quite few are good in decathlon. Just a few months ago, Janis Luzes died, and he was one of the best javelin thrower the world had. And he came from decathlon. He did just under 8,000 points. So important it's for athletes from 14 to 18, good endurance can be swimming, biking, running. I learned also here that athletes, even they can throw almost 90 meters, they have problems with swimming. That should be basics. Yeah. You should be well coordinated. Yeah. Learn different games, volleyball, basketball. Basketball here in India, nobody of my athletes knows rules or know how to play basketball. Yeah. So, very good. It's also badminton for javelin throwers. Gymnastic, handstand walking, cartwheels, other gymnastic exercises, saltos, or we used or introduced slack lines to using slack line to our athletes. will improve your coordination, will improve the way you learn things, and will help you with learning and doing technique changes. You should also be able to do other throwing events, like shot put, discus throw. Many different kind of medicine ball throws. One arm, two arms, overhead in laying position on the Swiss ball. And very important is running, speed work. My athletes told me also that they did runs regular, but not really sprinting. Not trying to be as fast as possible or increasing speed. It's very important. Jumps, high jump, long jump. If you learn these techniques, you will help also your throwing technique. Hurdle, running, jumping. And surely also throwing different implements. And even we in special phases of our preparation, when we work on speed work, we using light javelins. So Schiffball or Neeraj throwing also 600 gram javelins. It's very important to increase the release speed and be able to be fast, and will help also on learning how to throw. If you be able to switch between 800 gram and 700 and 600 gram direct after each other, and you be able to let them fly very nicely, then you have good control over your javelin and good feeling for javelin. And that's very important for all javelin throw. We also throw with very light implements for overspeed, for example, with golf balls. You should do it also in your age and try to throw as far as possible. Some of our athletes throwing about 125 meters, and I think normally should be also possible to throw 150 meters. That's important, the speed, release speed. The faster you are in with a light implement, that faster you can be on a javelin later with good technique, surely. Yeah, when you start, all things are difficult. Before they are getting easy. That's, you should know. Practice, practice, practice. And surely understanding what you're doing. Not only train harder, use your head and understand your event. Thank you. Here another throw from Neeraj. again for the end. Yeah, one word to this last throw from Neret. If he hit it, let it fly better, he would be able to throw 4 or 5 meter more. That much different make the fact to hit a javelin perfect. Yeah, thank you.